This is a video I said I was going to do quickly. My car. See the chips? Yeah. That's what people do. They go as far in. There's nothing wrong. There was nothing wrong with my motherfucking car 8-9 months ago. It would look just like that knob. Okay? I don't use these knobs enough to fucking have that. That's chip bullshit. That's what people do. That fucked up shit. That's what I'm talking about. Fucked up black magic. That's fuck with someone's car. Yeah. Meanwhile, someone drives their grandkids in the motherfucking car sometimes, you piece of shits. Get a life. Seriously, grow up. Fuck. Yeah, sorry. Don't like my swearing. Too bad, so sad. Just saying. Keep fucking with the person that's chosen to do the fucking shit she's doing. Like, fuck off. Yeah. You gotta love this shit. Bunch of spies. Grow up. Hitman. Black magic, fucking tattoos, people walking around with fucking cult tattoos on them, spying away, fuck, bunch of bullies, that's what it is, bunch of bullies. And I keep telling people, yeah, stop it, I'm not the only one, stop fucking with someone who actually has royal blood. You wanna see my DNA? Oh, hack my shit, you'll find it. Hack my shit, you'll find it. My mama's pissed, I have my mama's blood, and she's probably haunting everybody's ass at this point. Because you're fucking with the wrong person, doing a voodoo doll on the wrong person, attacking the wrong person, trying to poison them. Yeah, the motherfucking radiator too. I love that smell. That's a lovely smell. I hope you all get caught and go to jail. Because you're all being fucking watched. Don't think you're not. You're being hacked too, assholes. You can mirror your fucking bullshit across fucking seas if you want. You're still being hacked. What do you think they got friggin' satellite dishes for? People like you. Suck on that.
Really? Fucking with my car. You don't think I notice what you do in my car? Dumb? Dumb. 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 I keep to myself with good reason. This shit. Cut everybody out for a good reason. I grew up. That's the difference, I guess. Pisses people off because I grew up. I don't do threesomes. I don't do drugs. I don't do alcohol. I even quit smoking January. God forbid someone fucking smarten up in life, eh? Make a better fucking life. People wonder why the earth's the way it is, by the way.
Yeah, I ain't bending. Try to kill me, anyone. I already did that spell last full moon. People fucking kill me, or supposedly I commit suicide. Which, by the way, hope CIA is watching. I'll never do that. Good way to see that. If your throat's closed off a certain way, I ain't no doctor, but that'll show if someone actually made you, you know, forced it down your throat. Or a needle. Poisoning your food. I don't know. Disdain the fact. I got much more to live for. I was put on this earth to do a purpose. And ain't this bullshit that I'm living through. I'm proud of who I am. I don't sit there and cower behind fucking screens. Oh, there goes an undercover now. Speak of the devils. Oh, that's a good person, actually. I've been seeing Cadillacs, Men in Black. People drive by here fucking intimidating. One woman. One motherfucking woman. I got bigger balls than you people do. The shit you put me through. Stalkers. Hackers. Cults. Let's do black magic. We're tough. Oh, hypocrites. I pray for you.
I do. I really pray for you. Fucking with someone's car. Paying a fucking mechanic to fuck with it too. Immature shit. Try being happy.
I swear to God, I'm saying this straight up. I swear men are worse. I work with 13 of them. Believe me, I think. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying women are bad. But you get a bunch of men together, yeah. Especially exes. Because somebody doesn't want them anymore. There's a difference between karmics, soulmates. Karmic soulmates. They were brought into your life. I'm sorry, a soulmate will not sit there and pound on you. A soulmate will not sit there and mock you or gaslight you and call you every fucking name in the book. Nope. Won't sit there and say, oh honey, let's do a coke together. I'm just using an example, people. Don't bark up my ass because I'm saying it. Won't sit there and do crack together. That's a karmic. Duh. Not speak to you for 2 weeks. Karmic behavior. People, wake up. Nine times out of ten, you don't even have kids with the person you're supposed to be with. People take that away from people too, by the way. Creepy thing is, I know someone that had to have a hysterectomy, and three other people on that fucking street had the same thing. Same problem. Oh, you forgot to aim it at one house, maybe. Yeah. Get the fuck out of here. I can forgive. I'll never forget. I don't hate. I'm actually disgusted. And people wonder why the world is. Some people might want to take a look too around the fucking homeless. The actual homeless. I'm not talking about the undercover cops, because there's a lot of them out there. Watching all you fuckers who think you're so fucking God. It's coming. Keep pushing.
That's including the fucking stupid piece of shit assholes that come in the fucking apartment when they're not supposed to. I'm looking at one right now, by the way. Fuck with my shit. I don't care. It's only shit. State of fact. People are so rude. Slicing my fucking stems in my car. Hoping. Yeah, I drive a kid around. Kid.
Stupid fucks. You wanna fuck with me, fuck with me. But don't fuck with my car. I drive a fucking 8-year-old autistic at that who has autistic. Like, hear that? My car just popped. I drive a fucking kid and sometimes a fucking 4-year-old around my vehicle. Assholes. That's gutless. That's heartless. And I mean that straight up, heartless. Again, current behavior. People don't learn. Maybe you might want to try a fucking Dark Night of the Soul for once. Very painful, actually. So, enjoy hacking my shit. Stuart just drove by. I found out I'm related to Stuart's. I found out I'm related to Tate's. Jackson's too. And the other person is one of my nemesis. Have a treat with that. Suck on that. You might want to get your DNA done. You're fucking with your own cousin. Distant. I don't care. What was the other? Lewis. Need I go further? Blood's not thicker than water, I guess. Until you need them. Like I said, I don't hate the people I had in affairs with my fucking husbands or anything like that. I don't have no hate. In fact, I blame them. Like I said, I'm no fucking angel. I didn't do the right things the way I should have. I should have just walked away. But I was a karmic individual. And we all are. Anybody says they're not, you're so full of shit. You might want to get a fucking bulldozer for your shit. No one's perfect. And unfortunately, just because our parents stay in karmic marriages all our lives does not mean we condone that shit for our own kids. I didn't stay in mine. And these fake readers too. You're being called out. You should be ashamed of yourself for being even fucking paid to lie. As innocent some of you are, you're not. I know my motherfucking birth chart. And I do know a few others from 3 years ago when I looked at them. And I sure shit ain't friggin' someone's soulmate that says that I am or not. That's not the person I keep saying the fucking name of. Sucks to be them. So keep paying for your black magic. Keep using that voodoo doll, especially when I'm doing readings and poking my fucking heart, my head, my eyes. That's wow, aneurysm, eh? Mm. Have fun. That's so karmic, it's not even funny. I'll just say though, one is a soulmate that does that funky fuck shit. You should be ashamed of yourself. I just sit back and laugh now. I find it amusing. I no longer get migraines. My anxiety's gone like way down thanks to you assholes that started this shit in the first place. It got really bad in 2011 because they thought it was funny to go pay a fucking voodoo priestess. I feel sorry for you, lady, because your karma is really going to hit you. And yet you still pay for another practitioner. Not learned yet. Yeah. Just saying. And this TV bullshit, I'm already on you assholes. It's like you want someone to constantly be in pain. Really mature. Especially the ones that are doing it. I think I don't look that shut up. Fuck off. Let's put reoccurring TV shows on the fucking antenna we have. She won't know. Smoke some crack. You need Wi-Fi for that shit, don't you? Some people will actually give someone, they probably won't fucking match anyway, but actually give somebody their fucking kidney to help a person out because they're not a piece of shit. But that person sitting there fucking stabbing the person in the back the whole time. Whoa. I guess that's the difference between good people and people that are just downright fucking evil. And one of them is a soulmate. We all have different soulmates, by the way. I just know that I did a ritual last full moon. So I would really consider not fucking with me anymore. Because the next ritual I do, I might not be so nice. And I don't need a fucking practitioner to help me. Do you hear me? And I don't need your full names either. I'm not taking it no more. I'm so sick and tired of you people fucking with my life. When I stay to myself. And stop going on Facebook, whatever fucking account you're using with my name on, you can stop that anytime too. Same goes for dating sites. That's not me. I ain't on a dating site. I know better. I get catfished. I learned my lesson from that shit 3 years ago. You guys are nothing but boring and immature and have mental health issues, because that is mental health, by the way. Severe. You might want to get off whatever fucking crack pipe or whatever the fuck you're on, because there's something severely wrong with your brain or that drug. Just saying. And next person that sits there and calls me a gold digger, you better watch what you fucking say. I left a house to go with someone who made minimum wage from someone that was making almost $30 an hour. Fuck you and the horse you rode on. And I didn't ask for whatever he was asking for child support. That was his decision, not mine. Go fuck yourself. My first husband with my other daughter was $153 a month. Go fuck yourself. And I left all the furniture. Don't ever call me a gold digger again. And just because people sit there and think it's funny when I do go to jobs lately and text each other through fucking Facebook or whatever bullshit fucking apps you use, TikTok or whatever the fuck you're using, I think it's funny to harass a woman who actually is a good worker. And believe me, I have many, many fucking supervisors that wrote a note before they turned against me as well. Stating that. I never got fired from the jobs I was at before that. Never. In fact, I was praised. I worked with 13 men. I could literally whip the things around and drive a forklift like a man. Burn out like a man on a forklift. They thought I was going to quit 2 weeks. And I didn't. I showed them. I did that job, no problem. Plus, I helped other people that came in and couldn't do that job that were men. I would do their hats for them sometimes. To help them out. And I'm not her worker. I've worked since I was 14. Assholes. Kiss my ass on that one. I did forklift. I did cashier. Assistant manager. Restaurant. I even had my pharmacy tech. I chose not to do that. Because it was not accredited. In other words, we were lied to. So, yeah. Don't sit there and ever fucking call me a gold digger ever again. I will make you fucking eat those words. One day. See, I can give 5 bags to a homeless person without fucking blinking. Even when I was starving and eating peanut butter jelly sandwiches myself. Fuck you and the horse you rode on. Assholes. I would even give them my own fucking money that I made for tips just to make sure they eat when I could. So go fuck yourself. Sideways. I've had enough. And people should be more like Keanu Reeves and Johnny Depp, too. You rich pricks, bitches, whatever you want to call yourselves. You should know where you came from before you became that person. Some of you forgot. Compton, stuff like that. And don't look at me like I'm a fucking prejudice or anything, because I do have black in my fucking roots, too. And a lot of people do that are prejudiced. You people should be ashamed of yourself. If you look back at your DNA, you might just find out you have African American and you fucking assholes. And fucking Indian. And if you hate French, French too, because I'm just fine not shit out too. Just saying. You're all a bunch of hypocrites. All you. Anybody that has any fucking racism in you at all, you're all hypocrites. And should be ashamed of yourself. Everybody has fingers, toes, fucking eyes, nose, mouth, teeth, whatever. Get over yourselves fast. And people wonder why the world is the way it is today. Wow. Rich, poor, middle class. And the other thing, what about war? All these people are fighting for fucking countries and stuff, and yet they're asking for us to give them money. Why is the government not fucking paying these people that fucking fought for us in the first place? Explain that to me. Are you too busy fucking using satellite dish money? Yes, there is aliens. And they'll always be a fucking head of us anyway. This is my rant today. Just being honest. How about y'all go sit in teepees? Get some sage. Sage the evilness out of your fucking punk asses. Detox whatever the fuck you're on. Detox some of the toxic fucking friends, bitch friends at that. And I'm saying bitch, man and woman. If they're that toxic, kick them to the fucking curb and straighten your motherfucking life out. As hard as it may be, I don't care if you knew since you were 5 years old, I had to do it. It's not a friend, your friend's fucking your man. Or sister. Cousin, I don't care. See ya. Bye. Pieces, deuces, bye. Again, I'm not saying I was perfect. But now, I'm not again saying I'm perfect. Yes, I swear. I'll be damned if I'll ever be a person I was before. I'll be damned if a man will ever fucking lay his fingers on me ever again. I'll be damned if a man will ever try to fucking rape me ever again. Or cheat on me. You wanna cheat? See ya. I was with a rich person? Prenup. I don't want fucking none of your shit. You're gonna cheat on me? I'll take my shit, my car I came with, and fucking leave. And you can keep your fucking motherfucking ring. I don't need that shit. I don't need no man cheating on me. I could have exes come back to me today that were fucking turned out to be millionaires. And I'd say, fuck you and the horse you rode on. Bye. There's the door. See, I'm a Gemini. And once a fucking Gemini's done, we're done. See ya. You treat us like shit. You put us in a fucking corner. Done. And if you're gonna throw magic at us and stuff like that, fuck you. Look at yourself in the mirror. I have. Someone selling it for a ghost of me. And this is this one. You get a good woman or a man that's actually a soulmate. I'm not saying karmic. Because believe me, some of them are good. That's karmics, unfortunately. You treat them with respect. But when it comes to dating marriages and stuff like that, being partners, and that's including fucking friends. See ya. Again, I would never fuck on a friend's fucking man. Never. Or his sister's. Stepsister, whatever you want to call it. Cousin, anything. Just saying. And I sure she ain't gonna get some karmic stuff. Take someone's clothes, hide them, put them back to make them look like, ooh, crazy. Fuck off. Seriously. Like, grade 7 shit. Or put sugar in someone's gas tank. What the fuck?
A banana and tailpipe shit.
I get a joke. I just sit back and look. It's nice to sit and be alone. Oh, bird just flew me. It's nice to sit there without someone going, eh, in your ear. Or try to start fights intentionally to make you look like you're a fucking latch up. Never cease to amaze me how low people can go. That's including your landlords.
I got an idea. Let's fuck her up and do this and that.
Get paid. You're being watched, by the way. Or poisoning someone. You're being watched. You guys have been watched for a while. Yeah. Life insurance policy, too. Well. Ever occur to you someone was not supposed to die yet? It's called a mission. Breakout spells. How's that working out for you? You see anything broken out on me lately? Besides the little zit there. That's funny shit there. Your hair fall out. Does it look like my hair's falling out now? Assholes. Right, you see wrinkles? I thank God, universe, whoever, every day for roof, food, everything. Health. Everything daily since I've had my dark night of the soul and was eating peanut butter jelly sandwiches. Couple more literally. Days until kids graduate. Daily. I know that our general manager is watching his daughter graduate today from university. So until you're that low, you don't know nothing. Until you lose everything, lose everybody, you don't know fucking shit. Oh. Stocking. Pretty sad sounds like you can't even fucking go to a store without pieces of shit following you around. Who don't even know you from a hole in their ass. Bored, I guess. So to the fake readers that's coming out and saying bullshit, fuck yourself sideways. To the ones that are doing black magic, again, fuck yourself sideways. Hell's coming for you. And to these people that have all this money and think they can get away with the bullshit they're doing, that think again. Money cannot buy people's souls out. I'm a firm believer in reincarnation and hell and heaven. Big time. Why do you think some people that actually do die and come back to life and say, I saw the light? What do you think the motherfucking light was? Think about that. I've been zapped by, what's that called? Like electricity from a appliance type thing? And it didn't tickle, I can tell you that. I can walk around sometimes on wood floor and zap someone now. You know, carry shit. Sometimes my radio in my car will just go off and on. In fact, the other day I did it and I didn't have my motherfucking keys in my car. Suck on that. God can take your gifts away so fast, it's not even funny. That being said,
I got a jar of dirt. Oh, shit. I had to laugh at that. Toodles to Johnny Depp. I got a jar of dirt. You're supposed to ask for permission when you do shit like that, by the way. The same. Same as when you take things from plants and stuff, you're supposed to ask permission. Me, I'm the type of person that like cheap freaking flowers, not $100, $200 roses, whatever they cost nowadays. I like little fucking lilies, dandelions, carnations, the cheap shit for $10. I'm not a gold digger. In fact, I'm the type that can go to a store, walk out of there with a whole year's fucking wardrobe under $200 sometimes. You know, urban planet type stuff. I don't need stilettos. I don't need to go get Brazilian butt. I'm proud of my ass. I'm proud of my tatas. I don't need nose job or nothing. I'm proud of what God gave me. Tattoos, I would love to get them, but I choose not to because I don't want to mark up my body that way. Nothing against tattoos, but I did want one with butterfly with the eyes that's purple with my daughter's names on them. Back in the day, though, I chose not to because of Hep B and C. Some people are nasty. The only thing I did get was my belly button done. And my ears. Besides that, I wouldn't get it. As much as I like to. I chose Hannah instead. Can't trust anybody nowadays anyway. I don't even care if you own a freaking 20 shops. You never know. Besides that, though. Like I said, I'm the type of person that will go and spend $200 in a whole year's wardrobe. And don't get me wrong, I like American Eagle, but I refuse to pay that much money. I used to like Jean Machine, but I refuse to pay up to $200 for a fucking pair of jeans. I used to pay $20 when I was a kid. That's disgusting. I don't care if it's silver or not. Some of them aren't even fucking comfortable anymore anyway. American Eagle is, but still, I'll wait until they're on sale. Fuck that shit. Call me cheap. I don't give a rat's ass. I go Dollarama. Fuck you. Apparently people have an issue with that. Or Walmart. Well, excuse me. Bloody da da.
So, gold digger? No. So, shove your comments up your ass. In all honesty, if I won a few billions or millions of dollars, like, I don't know, 5 mil or something, I would pay the idiots back to shut their fucking mouth and leave me alone with taxes. Say thank you. Now leave me the fuck alone. Yeah. If you think I owe you this much, here you go. Don't ever contact me again. And here's interest. Have a nice life. Don't mention my name ever again in your fucking toxic tongue. Trauma bond. That's what it is. Trauma bond. Thank you. Hell, I probably even pay someone's mortgage. Just to say thank you. As my car made that noise.
I don't know. That's the type of person I am, though. I guess I'm different than other people. Some. There are some good people out there. Born and raised Catholic, didn't want to go to church, was forced to. Now I look at Hindu stuff and Indian. Do I think there's a God? I believe in the universe, no. Do I believe in aliens? Oh, fuck yeah. I got reasons to. Seen three ships with someone one night. We're sitting outside and you saw three ships. They were not flying planes, I can tell you that right now. Don't know. Apparently, Pleiadian. I can't even say it right now.
Anyhow, that's my spiel. I said I was going to show what fucktards like to do with my goddamn car. Let's take some chips of it and do some black magic because we're immature as fuck. And bored with our life. And miserable. Miserable. That's miserable. That's karmic shit. Fucking with someone's car. Over a life insurance policy, I think. Wow. Sad. Some people did never learn. So if you're gonna do some more candle work or voodoo doll stuff, you might want to consider putting it down, taking it apart, I don't know. Stop calling the practitioner and do fuck shit on people. Yeah, my nose has been broken, by the way. Amazing. People can sit there and call you every name of the book. I guess for standing up, I don't know. You tell me. So, yeah, that's been my spiel about my vehicle and the black magic and, oh, and people taking my cards that I had prior. Now I have new sets I like better. And I even unsubscribed to certain readers that are full of shit. Yeah. Taking bribery money, I wouldn't care if someone gave me $1 million to feed someone a bunch of bullshit. Fuck that. I believe in karma. Fuck that. I'm no idiot. People might want to stop feeding people bullshit to tell on the channels. That's just fucked up shit there. That's creating so much karma. Actually, that's creating karma for your own, if you know what I'm saying. People are so stupid. And to the dude who visited me in my dreams, I hope you have a lovely day. And thanks for the music. And you're awesome. Anybody tells you different, tell them to go fuck themselves. Oh, and I'm here and watch your friends. Some of them aren't friends. But thank you for the music. I appreciate it. And to the skank that has the voodoo doll, please put that thing down. And stop sending me shit, too. You might want to get some help for that. As you hear sirens in the background. You don't know me from a hole in the ass. And your minions. So, yeah. I'm ready. So, thank you for the lovely songs, because it is a soulmate that sends them to me. I appreciate it very much. And, yeah, keep doing your own mantras or sage or whatever you're doing. There's a lot of evil fuckers out there who's very jealous. And watch who your friends are. Because there's a lot of evil people out there that know other people. That are just fucking evil. Literally. I'm looking at one right now, actually.
That being said, I'm going now. After I spray. I made my own Florida water.
Yeah. You gotta love your neighbors. I hate your guts. And the things that you don't know.
I spray you out of my aura. You crazy ass bitch. Loony, 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 loony.
especially the ones that live where I am in the basement. Two have gone, thank God. Like, I was not stupid. You got another crazy ass bitch down here. It's a fucking voodoo witch or some bullshit. I'm not stupid. Then you got another crazy fucker on the front end. Like, Mr. Yoda person. And they think I'm stupid. I'm crazy. That's lunatic shit. Like, need help shit. And people wonder why I keep to myself. Oh, we got so-called family and ex-friends and people that didn't know you from a hole in the ground just listen to what other people have to say, and just evil-ass people in general. Yeah, you decide you want to stay the fuck away from people. People fucking with your car, slicing your tires, doing all that fuck shit. Getting accident spells and all that bullshit. Yeah, you need to stay away. I'm a high OK empath. There's certain people I just cannot be around without fucking vibrating off a wall. Literally. Like, they could have a fucking rose cross on their ass and you could still smell the evil off these people. I'm not kidding. You can go to church and still have fucking the shakes from being next to these people. Hypocrites. You know what I'm saying? So, whatever a cross watcher is, you might want to watch The Nun. A preview. Oh, what was the other movie I keep saying? Hellraiser. Oh, and my favorite, apparently other people's favorite, Scream. Halloween. The Stranger series on Netflix. Just watch like 1 minute of it and follow the readings. Cross watching. The song Forever Young keeps playing in my head and I'm getting warm. Seven Wonders. Oh, American Horror Stories is the other one. Cross watcher. I'm not saying the karmic assholes either, but you can watch because obviously you do. You follow all the time. And hack away. What was the other movie? There's another movie. I don't think of it. She-Wolf. Listen to She-Wolf? Shakira. Go figure.
That's it. That's my spew. Mine was just bitching that people fuck with my car. I don't care anymore. I believe someone up above will provide and is protecting me, and people wonder why they have bad luck. Bad things come in three. Some people continuously who don't learn. Just saying. The world would be so much happier and sun bright all the time if people would just fuck off and leave people they just don't like alone and move on with your life. It's not hard. You don't have to be dickheads about it. I'm no angel. I came off Facebook and then I apologized for any fuck shit I said on there. That was true, by the way. I apologize. Wrong thing to do. But at least I apologize. You think one person ever fucking apologized to me about fucking anything? Don't care. Don't expect it. Don't want it. Just saying. I no longer give a shit. I know who was not my friend. Not many. Heavy, where's the crown I just heard? Speaking of a piece of shit so-called friend. Wow. It's amazing. People throw rocks, hide their hands. In my case, sometimes knives. Certain people I don't wish bad at all still to this day. Actually, hope they heal. Literally, hope they heal. Take one good look in the mirror. I dare you. What do you see? I can look in the mirror all the time. and smile and say, I love you. How many people do you know can really do that? Then you'll know the dark night of the soul. That sucker brings you to your knees.
Same as my children who totally are against me now, my daughters, and that's fine. I love them with all my heart.
They've been poisoned and that's all good with me. Again, if I ever won the lotto, I'd still be there for my daughters because they are my daughters. And my grandkids. Always be a part of me. Regardless. Just saying. But everybody else. See ya. Deuces.
Like I said,
if I went to the lottery, I'd be sending my kids new cars in a heartbeat. Just to say hey. With a bow on them. And probably buy my one youngest a house under my name. And the other pay for her shit. That's millions, by the way. And I would definitely donate to the homeless, for sure. And mental health, for sure. Oh, my bad, and animals. Some people just don't deserve fucking animals, especially assholes that think it's funny killing them. You're fucked. That's man's best friend, you piece of shit. Or train them to kill each other. Like, what the fuck? Get the fuck out of here. Anyhow, that's been my rant. I love animals. I had a horse. My parents' best friend named Amarella. She was an Arabian horse. That's how I learned. Unfortunately, I found out that man died. Good man to me, I remember. I used to sit there and play with a bull. He lost his shit, apparently, because I was petting the bull like it was a dog. And this bull apparently attacked a man. And here I am, a little 8-year-old, if I'm that, petting a motherfucking big bull.
Nice bully. Nice bully.
They'd even send me in to get chickens and their eggs. I think with animals and pets. What can I say? That's the other thing about the gold digger. I think that's funny. I gave my kids an option to help fix a piece of shit that ran over our dog Christmas time. And it would have cost us, well, it did cost us over $1,600 when all said was done. You have a choice. You either help fix the dog and not get nothing for Christmas. Well, they got some stuff, but nothing like they were supposed to. Or you just be an asshole and speaking of the devil. And pay for the dog to get help, surgery-wise.
That's my spew. I better go because I'm going to get my ass chewed because food's not ready. Narcissism to its max. Gaslighting. Have a good day. And thanks for the love songs, dude. Till we meet. Bye.